Hello, this is Matthew Chan of WebDominationStrategies.com, and in this video I want to talk about the importance of Facebook pages as it relates to creating an internet and web presence. So, everyone has heard about Facebook, and chances are if you're watching this video, there's a good chance you have a Facebook account. Now, what some people might not know is, in addition to having an individual Facebook account, is that you can have a Facebook page, which can represent a business, a website, a cause that you are involved in, a hobby, whatever you want it to be. In essence, a Facebook page is an extension of you as an individual. A Facebook page is an extension of you, your interests, and your business. So, how does a Facebook page serve you? Well, a Facebook page is not limited by the number of members that can join up. I know a lot of people who have Facebook pages and use them for business purposes, except that a lot of these people run up against the 5,000 friend limit, and that is a big problem. Once you get to the 5,000 friend limit, the only way to get beyond that is to create a Facebook page, which has no limit to the number of people that can view it. Now, most recently, Facebook has made a change that allows subscribers to view any post that you would want to share, but this is a fairly recent development. And so as far as the long-term ramifications and the execution, how this works, remains to be seen. What I do know about Facebook pages is they are well established and they are definitely indexed by the search engines, especially Google. There have been many, many times where I've been searching on a particular topic and it would lead me to a Facebook page. So I know it definitely works. Now, I have to say, I am partial to Facebook as a social media. I mean, I like Facebook better than I do Twitter, because I find Facebook to be more representative of who I am. I can incorporate more words, for example, and, you know, more photos, and, you know, there's more flexibility to put information in different ways than Twitter is. For me, Twitter is something that is still difficult for me. I mean, I understand conceptually how to do it. I know how to do the posting, but I hate having to post in small nuggets. I mean, I hate having to shorten my thoughts. I hate having to, you know, make everything within 200 and some odd characters. It's just not my style. I like a little more room to maneuver, but that's just me. In any case, for the here and now, if you intend to set up an internet web presence for your business or your product, you're going to need to set up a Facebook page. One thing I'd like to remind you is you need to think abundantly. Most people think with scarcity, meaning they think, well, I should only do one page or maybe two pages. But the reality is, if you're able to maintain it, of course, that's usually a limiting factor, I would not stop at just simply one or two Facebook pages. For me, I've got a Facebook page for Tempest Broadcasting for my shows. I've got a Facebook page for my publishing. I've got a Facebook page for me as a consultant. I've got a Facebook page for this subject matter, web domination strategies. And I've got a Facebook page, for example, for my real estate site. So I have a Facebook page which caters to a different audience. If you have some thoughts and ideas relating to Facebook pages as it relates to creating an internet presence, I'd love to hear from you. Please leave a comment below. Thank you for watching this video, and I'll see you in my next video.